Hello friends, welcome to our channel tutorial.com. So today we are going to discuss about irrational number. Let's just quickly revise this topic. So if p is a prime number and if p divides a square, then p divides a also, where this a is a positive integer. So if you add or subtract one rational and one irrational number, the answer turns out to be a rational number. And even if you multiply one rational and one irrational number, if you divide one rational and irrational number, the answer turns out to be irrational. And if p is a prime number, then root p is irrational. Let's understand more about this topic by the example. So in this video, I have discussed all the types of questions that can come in the exam. So if you just understand these examples, this topic will be clear to you. Okay, so let's just do the first question. We have to prove that root 7 is irrational. Okay, these type of question usually comes with 3 or 4 mark, but definitely such type of question come in exam. So we have to prove that root 7 is irrational. How will you start? So let us assume to the contrary that root 7 is rational. So we have to start with the contradiction. Fine. So we'll assume that root 7 is rational. So if it is a rational number, obviously it can be written as in the form of a upon b. So root 7 is equal to a upon b, where this a and b are co-prime. So once you will cross multiply, what you will get? B into root 7 is equal to a. Now what you will do, you will square the both the sides. So on squaring both the sides, we'll get 7b square is equal to a square. Now here a square is divisible by 7, so that means a is also divisible by 7. Now what you will do for such type of question, for this term, you will take this a as whatever number is given to you into c, where the c stands for some integer. Fine. So let's take a is equal to 7c. Now you will put this value of a in this equation. Clear? So what you will get, 7b square is equal to 49c square. So we can cancel 7 and 49. So what you will get? 7. Fine. So that means b square is equal to 7c square. That means b square is divisible by 7 and b is also divisible by 7. But we assume that a and b are co-prime. That means they should not have common factors other than 1. But here a and b have at least 7 as a common factor. So that means this will contradict the fact that a and b are co-prime. And this contradiction is there because we have assumed that root 7 is rational. So our assumption is incorrect and therefore root 7 is irrational. So last year in 2019, this question was there in CBSE board exam for 4 marks. So you just have to write all these steps, no extra step is required, and then you will get whole full marks. Okay, next type. Here you may get one rational number and then some or difference is given to you and one irrational number, and you have to prove that it's irrational. Now the main problem with this question is students do a blunder in this question. Why? Because they write, we know that sum or difference of rational and irrational number is irrational, therefore this is irrational. No, we don't have to use that concept. Fine. You have to prove it is irrational. How will you start? Again, the starting will remain same, that we will assume that 8 minus root 3 is rational. Whatever number is given to you, you will start with the fact that this is rational. And if it is rational, then it can be written in the form of a upon b. So we can write 8 minus root 3 is equal to a upon b, where a and b are co-prime. Now just take all the rational numbers one side and irrational number other side. Fine. We know that root 3 is rational, but we need to prove it. Fine. So what we will do, we will take all the rational numbers one side. So once you will take this a upon b to other side, you will get 8 minus a upon b and minus root 3 to this side. So you will get is equal to root 3. Now just take the LCM. Once you will take the LCM, what you will get? B. 8b minus a is equal to root 3. Now we know that 8a and b are rational number. So 8b minus a upon b is also a rational number. And if LHS is equal to RHS and one side is rational number, second side will obviously be a rational number. But this contradicts the fact that root 3 is irrational. So this contradiction has arisen because of an incorrect assumption that 8 minus root 3 is rational. So we conclude that 8 minus root 3 is irrational. So hope this question is clear to you. Let's move to the third type. Now we have two irrational numbers. Fine. Root 5 minus root 3. Whenever two irrational numbers are given to you and you need to prove that the sum or difference is also irrational, you will take the square on both the sides, squaring both the sides. Starting will remain same. Root 5 minus root 3 is irrational. So root 5 minus root 3 can be written in the form of a upon b, where a and b are coprimes. Squaring both the sides. So you will use a minus b whole square property here. So a square, which will give you 5. Root 5 into root 5 is 5. Plus b square, that means root 3 square, will give you 3. Minus 2ab. 2 into root 5 into root 3 will give you root 15. So 5 plus 3 is 8. 8 minus 2 root 15. Now this is equal to a upon b. Again, like the second question, will take a upon b to other side. So what you will get? 8 minus a upon b is equal to 2 root 15. Take the LCM. So you will get 8b minus a upon. Now you can take this 2 to this side. 2b is equal to root 15. Just avoid this mistake. Kids write 8 minus a upon 2b. This is wrong. First of all, you need to take the LCM and then you will divide this 8 minus a, 8b minus a upon by 2. Okay, so this is equal to root 15. Now we know that 8, a, b and 2 are rational number. Again, if one side is rational, second side should also be rational, because these two are equal. That means root 15 should be a rational number, but this contradicts the fact that root 15 is irrational. So this contradiction has arisen because of an incorrect assumption that root 5 minus root 3 is rational. So we conclude that root 5 minus root 3 is irrational. Okay, next type is where you get the product or numbers in quotient form. So for example, if I want to prove that 2 root 5 is irrational, fine, starting will remain same. You will write it as in the form of a upon b. Fine, you can take 2 to other side, you'll get a upon 2b. And again, then you will prove that since a, b, 2 are rational number, so the concept will remain same. So root 5 is also a rational number, but root 5 is irrational, so this is irrational, 2 root 5, okay. So likewise, you can do all the questions. You can visit our website for such type of questions. Let's just quickly summarize what we have learned. So if P divides A square, then P divides A also, where P is a prime number and A is a positive integer. Sum or difference of one rational and one irrational number will give you irrational number. Product of one rational and irrational number will give you irrational number. And division of one rational and irrational number will give you irrational number. Okay, I hope this topic is clear to you. If you have any doubt, please comment. Please write your query in the comment box. Do visit our website for the test material, for the study material. And please don't forget to subscribe to our channel. Share our channel for more science and maths videos. Just wait for the next video. Till then, take care. Stay safe. Bye.